Hello and welcome to the Craft Beer Corner. For today's review, we are going to be reviewing a couple of stouts. Another stout review coming at you. Today we've got very much classic stout. This is Left Hand Brewing Company's Milk Stout. It's the Nitro version and it's 6% ABV. Left Hand is based out of Longmont, Colorado. And then completely different, we've got a non-traditional stout. We've got New Holland Brewing's Dragon's Milk White, which is a bourbon barrel aged white stout. This one is also 6% ABV and they are based out of Holland, Michigan. Now we did the regular Dragon's Milk, several reviews back, and now we're doing the white version of that same stout. So I'm really excited to see how this compares to their standard in the white form. And it'll also be interesting to compare it side by side with very much a standard formula for a stout. Albeit this one has the nitro widget in it, hence the nitro. So it's going to form like it's been pulled off of a tap at a bar. This on the left hand. Guinness has some CO2 widgets as well, and some of theirs as well. So very, very cool. Makes for a really nice stout drinking experience at home. So two stouts I can't wait to jump into. We're gonna start with the classic stout, the Left Hand. And again, this one's 6% ABV. Okay, jumping into our first beer of today's stout review, we've got Left Hand Brewing Company's Nitro Milk Stout. Again, they're based out of Longmont, Colorado, and it is 6% ABV. Not really much in terms of a bottle or a can art to show or tell, is quite plain. So let's just go ahead and get this cracked and listen carefully. That is the sound of the widget making that tap-like carbonation for this stout. So you can already see it looks quite creamy as we pour it, just as you would see in a bar. So this, if you've ever had the Guinness widgeted stouts that they have in the cans, it's the same concept. And indeed, it looks exactly how a stout does in a bar when they're forming their head. It's got that insane rush of super, super, super fine carbonation that comes flowing up to the top. You can already see as it's forming here, this head. I'll try to tilt it just a little bit. I know it's basically impossible to see, but this is just as thick and creamy and pillowy a foamy head as you can possibly get at home. These stouts with the nitro widgets, they're pretty spectacular. Quite effervescent, and it's very, very slow. What may look kind of dusty on the side of the glass in the camera, that is the slow-moving, super fine carbonation that's slowly working its way up from the bottom of the beer and up the sides of the glass. That's why it creates such thick, dense, luscious, silky, creamy foam. And it just sticks to your finger. That's just how it comes off a tap at a bar. It is absolutely lovely. Typically, I would give these several minutes to settle. It's just got the fine little residual still on the edge of the glass. This head is mostly formed, and unlike with most beers, I'm not going to break this down, so there's no question it's going to make an absolute mess in my beer, but such are the small sacrifices we make in the pursuit of a great stout. Holding it up visually, it's a classic stout. It's very, very dark. It's so thick and it's still got so much carbonation. It's hard to tell, except at the very bottom, I can see that I can see a little light through it where it's not pitch, pitch black, but it is a little occluded at the moment from my vision, just due to this tight carbonation that the widget forms. Let's give it a sniff. Now, even with this thick, pillowy, creamy, just marshmallow-like head on there, you can smell this stout. It smells very, very roasty, smells very deeply roasted malts. and it has a slight coffee aroma to it as well. So yeah, it's roasted malt and a nice coffee edge. You can smell that it's got a deep roast. And this is a milk stout, so it's going to be sweetened. It's going to have some lactose in there to sweeten it up and cut through some of that roasty edge. So yeah, it's going to be classic nitro milk stout. So let's just jump right in and weather the foam all up in my beard and take it for a spin. Oh yeah. Oh, it's been a very, very long time since I've had this beer. Many, many years. It's so good and it's so easy to find. I don't know why I don't buy this regularly. That's a fantastic stout. In terms of a milk stout, this is much more akin to those which I personally care for. Sure, it's a milk stout. It's got a little lactose, but it doesn't have an overabundance. It's not pungently sweet. It's got just enough to give you a hint and add a depth to the beer that otherwise wouldn't be there without actually making it come off as a sweet beer and ruining all of the intricacies of the deeply, richly roasted malts. So it's exceptionally well balanced how they did this one. Honestly, many, many milk stouts, I'd say the majority, especially if it's standard non-flavored milk stout, I don't go for them as well because it just kind of cuts through all of the roast of the malt bill, which for my money is really what a stout's all about. This is really quite nice. I'm going to jump in for body and mouthfeel, then we'll explore how this flavor develops. The body is medium to medium heavy. It's not super dense and super weighty, but it's heavier than I would expect for a 6% ABV. The mouthfeel is absolutely silky smooth. If you even start rolling it around the palate at all, it gets beyond creamy, as you might anticipate, just due to the nature of the carbonation that the widget forms. It's just lush. Everything about this is smooth and creamy and lush. Beautifully, beautifully balanced beer between the malt and the slight sweetness. So I'm going to jump in one final time here so I can explain how the flavors develop and finish. Up front, first you get a slight sweetness mixed with malt. The malt intensifies in flavor presence and really accentuates the roasty edge of the malt. It's very, very deeply roasted. It's got a nice classic stout roasted malt character to it with some coffee undertones. The coffee undertones aren't as pronounced in the flavor of the beer as they come through in the aroma of the beer, but they're definitely there. The normal deep roasted malt is what comes through in the strongest presence, and then it's got coffee undertones behind it. There's a slight char to it, but it's not oppressive. It's not like a French roast coffee bean kind of edge to it, and it certainly doesn't take on really any smoky characters. There's an element of this that reminds me a bit of a Scotch ale just behind because it's got such deep, intense roast to the malt. But again, it's without imparting a massive coffee-forward flavor to it, and without imparting smokiness. It's just that deep, rich, almost earthy roast to the malt, and it's absolutely fantastic. This is really a malt bill that tastes like what I think of in my mind when I think of what's a stout taste like. It tastes like this. And what's a milk stout taste like? Well, it tastes like this. This is slightly sweetened. It's clearly sweeter than a standard stout, but it's not sweet by any stretch of the imagination. This is not a milk stout I would term to be a sweet milk stout. It's got just enough to counterbalance that deep roastiness without overdoing it. It almost reminds me of if you have a deeply roasted mug of coffee and you put just a tiny bit of sugar in it, just enough to take some of the edge off. That's what this reminds me of. It is balanced absolutely beautifully, absolutely beautifully. This is a truly, truly fantastic stout. It's been a long time. It's been awesome jumping back in. I'm gonna take my time sipping on this, count my scores. When we come back, we will get to our second beer of today's stout review. That's the New Holland Brewing's Dragon's Milk White, which is a bourbon barrel aged white stout. That one's out of Holland, Michigan, and also 6% ABV. Okay, now moving on to beer number two of today's stout review. We've got New Holland Brewing's Dragon's Milk White. This is a bourbon barrel aged white stout at 6% ABV, and this is out of Holland, Michigan. Label art, this is very similar, if you recall, from the standard Dragon's Milk. It's got the dragon theme logo. It's so hard to avoid the glare with these set lights. They're very bright LEDs, I apologize, but it's got the dragon on there. It looks really cool. Very clean. They were established in 97. That's awesome. I didn't know that about them. So they've been around a while as a craft brewer. They've been around the scene, you know, going on 25 years, not too far off. Let's get this one cracked. All right. Ah, sound of beauty. And pour it straight in the glass. And immediately, you see the vast, vast difference. This is a white stout. It is called thusly because it's not black like a normal stout. Brewed in the same manner, brewed with many of the same ingredients, only white. So how do you make a stout white? That's another video for another time. I'll get to that into my Where We Dig in Deep beer series, which is coming up. It's one of my biggest first sight series I'm doing, starting probably in the next week, week and a half. By the time you're watching this, it will already be live because I record well in advance so I don't get behind because I have a very demanding day job. This is just a side project I do for fun. But I stay 6 months ahead, so you'll be watching this sometime in mid to late February, and I'm recording this in very early September. But nonetheless, holding this up visually, this looks very much like a textbook white stout. This is how they appear. They're a very light beer color, completely different from their dark stout counterparts, but they bear all of the characteristics and traits of a stout just without that depth of color. It's not dissimilar to when people first started brewing brown and dark sours. Most people think of sours as light, that hay straw color, and then people started making dark versions. And oh my God, it's a dark sour. Yeah, I know, it's amazing. And there's whole different layers of complexity to each of these substyles, and it's part of what makes the beer world so unique. I absolutely love it. This is only the second, maybe the third, but I think it's the second white stout I've ever had. The first one I had, I remember as clear as day, I was blown away. It does kind of a mind trip because you don't expect what's coming, even though you know it's a stout, but you see it and visually like, okay. And then it's a stout. You're drinking it and it looks like an IPA, but it's a stout. And this is pretty much right in line with the standard color of an IPA, but it's a white stout. So let's give it a sniff. Oh, that smells very nice. That's got a very pronounced aroma. You can definitely pick up the bourbon barrel. And it's a nice mix of bourbon and the malt bill that's in this beer. That really comes through in the aroma. It absolutely does. And it smells fantastic. I can't iterate that enough. Oh, God. There's bits of this that remind me of chocolate. It's like chocolate and bourbon married and decided to have a baby, and this is kind of their aromatic love child. Sorry for the crass kind of description there, but that's what it reminds me of. It's got all these interesting layers of complexity to the aroma, and the bourbon does come through, no question about it. The bourbon and the wood of the barrel, I'm guessing it's oak, some kind of oak. It reminds me most strongly of oak. I've had many barrel aged beers. I know what many different woods impart in terms of aroma and flavor. This, the aroma smells most strongly to me of oak. So I am guessing that it's bourbon barrels aged in an oak barrel. And I'm getting that strongly. I'm getting the malt and just hints of chocolate. Strong hints of chocolate. So it might have some chocolatey character to this beer, but head held okay. It formed pretty well. It's holding okay. Certainly it's without a widget. No nitro tap like the prior, but still looks good for port at home. Let's jump in and give this a sip. Oh, have mercy. Oh, that's delicious beer. Oh my gosh. Okay. I've got to center myself. Wow. Wow. Oh, that just gets better the longer the finish goes. Oh, sweet God. Oh, that is amazing. Okay. Okay. Focus. All right. First thing, you get this beer in your mouth. There's no question in your brain, despite the appearance, this is a stout. This is a stout beer. You get it in your mouth and you get classic stout notes, and immediately behind that you get bourbon. Very strong bourbon, very strong barrel. And that chocolate I was detecting in the aroma really comes strongly through in the flavor. And I'll tell you, it tastes to me like the chocolate notes it's imparting is about a 50-50 milk chocolate to white chocolate. So it's a lot of cocoa butter and a lot of milk chocolate. So there's that sugary edge to the chocolate that's been mixed with the milk. So it's that lighter, sweeter side of chocolate mixed with the fattier side that's got that, you know, 85%+ cocoa butter content. And it's kind of a meld of the two. And it comes through strongly. And it pairs just perfectly with the bourbon that comes through in this beer. And then those two flavors combine and they open up just into a huge bloom of buttered toffee. It's caramel and toffee and buttered and butter rum and butterscotch and all of these rich, buttery, earthy, kind of boozy characters that come through that the barrel mixes with the malts, and just this chocolate undertone to it. So it's kind of a mix of a, if you took milk chocolate and melted it down into equal parts of white chocolate and then poured that into some buttered rum or buttered scotch, that's what comes through in this flavor. It is so good. It is so good. I can't even begin to describe to you how good this tastes. And then you get this buttered popcorn that comes through and it lingers on the top with like this bourbon tease. It's just like tapping you, hey, Mr. Popcorn. Look at me, I'm bourbon. And it is just so good. This beer is insanely good. I can't state that enough. I absolutely love it. I'm gonna focus, I'm gonna jump in. I'm going to explore the body and the mouthfeel and start to think about how the flavors develop. I'll jump in for a final sip to see how they all pan out. But I can tell you before I even do that, this is an impeccably balanced white stout. I absolutely love it. I am very much looking forward to coming to my scores when I criticize this, but let's jump in and give you some more intel. The body, it's actually not as heavy as you'd expect for 6%. I'd say this is medium light, which is lower than I expect for A, a stout, and B, for a 6% ABV beer. But the mouthfeel is a little bit more present than the body. It's got a little more viscosity to it. It's got a little more thickness, though it's not creamy. It's got a thickness without being creamy. I don't want to say it's effervescent. It just doesn't cream up when it rolls around the palate, but it's got a thickness to it. So the two kind of balance out. A little slightly less weighty body to a little more thick mouthfeel. And I'm not talking sticky, thick, jammy. It's not like that. But the mouthfeel is more in a line to a 6% than the body is to a 6%. Let's put it that way. So the two kind of coalesce and they get in the range. It's okay. I'd say it's kind of hovering in average combined for the two. Flavors, it's just so complex. It's got so much going for it and it's so complex. I'm going to have to make one final dive here to pinpoint exactly what happens on this flavor ride, and it's just so freaking enjoyable. I wish you could taste and smell what I'm experiencing right now. I'm hoping that I'm doing it justice through this camera for you, so you get equally as excited and seek this out yourself, because this is a home run of a beer. Let me jump in. Let's explore together. Oh, sweet Lord. Okay. You first get it in your mouth and you get classic stout characteristics, and then you were overcome by this bourbon barrel back. The bourbon barrel rises to the front very quickly, and you get bourbon and you get the barrel, and the barrel still feels very much like oak to me. So the wood of the barrel and the bourbon that's in it comes through, and then you start getting all this nuance from the beer and the malt bill itself. And the first thing that comes out immediately and presently and big and bold and in your face is chocolate. And it's that 50-50 balance of milk chocolate and white chocolate. And it is just heavenly, and it pairs beautifully with this insanely present bourbon barrel, bourbon just presence that comes through in this beer. That comes through, and then slowly from the depths start to creep in the other qualities of the malt bill. And that's really when you start to know, hey, I'm actually drinking a stout, even though it's white and it's been barrel aged. You start to get the roastiness. And the way that it develops is very interesting, and it's a slow creep. It creeps its way through that bourbon, and it creeps its way through that barrel. It starts to slowly blossom up. And it's not as intense as a standard stout. The edge of the roast of the malt is not as deep or pronounced, but it does come through, and it still tastes big. It's a big presence that comes through and cuts through the bourbon and cuts through the oak, I presume oak, that cuts through the wood of the barrel. But then it takes on this insanely, insanely deep buttery character. And the buttery character opens up into buttered toffee, buttered scotch, and buttered rum, constantly pairing with that bourbon and the wood of the barrel. And it's just a hodgepodge of butter and toffee and caramel and rum and scotch and wood and malt and chocolate. And it's all just mashing. And it's subtle. I don't want to sound like it's chaotic in the way that the flavor develops. It's not at all. It's very subtle and it's very nuanced, but it's very, very present how this presents itself. This beer is so good. It is so good. I absolutely love it. This is a very, very complex beer. It's well done. It's exceptionally well balanced. I'm gonna take my time, sip on this, really deliberate my scores in each category. When we come back, we will get both beers ranked from top to bottom. Okay, now that we've gotten to enjoy both of these beers, we're gonna get them ranked, starting with the Left Hand Brewing's Milk Stout. This is the Nitro Milk Stout, 6% ABV, based out of Longmont, Colorado. Starting with the aroma on this one was nice. You could certainly smell the malt back, but it wasn't particularly pronounced. Had a nice thick head, which kind of got in the way of letting the aroma escape out of the glass. So it's hard, but it was a lovely beer. Still not a super pronounced aroma. I gave it high end of average there. I gave it a 6. For the taste, absolutely fantastic. This had all the hallmarks of a classic stout, and then that slight sweetness from the lactose, making it a milk stout. But the way that they balanced the flavors was just exceptional. Everything about it came through and really let the depths of the malt bill come through, which is exactly what you want in a stout. I give it a perfect 10 out of 10. For the body on this, fantastic body. Even more robust than you would expect for 6%. Really had presence. Nice bit of weight in the mouth, and give it a nice feeling to go along with the creaminess from the nitro. Give it a perfect 10 out of 10. mouthfeel, as you might expect being a nitro. It was just silky smooth, absolute textbook stout. You know, it's like having one pulled from the tap, but at home. That's the beauty of these little nitro widgets. Fantastic, perfect 10 out of 10 for the mouthfeel. Finish on this one. Finish on this beer is certainly above average, you know, it's a standard stout. It's not an imperial. Got a decent bit of linger on the malts, but it wasn't top tier. It was above average. It gets a 7 out of 10. Head and retention, that's about as perfect as it gets. It gets a perfect 10 out of 10. Appearance-wise, textbook stout. It was nice, deep, rich black. You could see just a hint of light under. Again, it's just a standard stout, not an imperial. It's exactly what I expected to see. It gets a 10 out of 10. For the balance for me was key on this beer, especially with a milk stout. Oftentimes, they can be overpoweringly sweet. This let the sweetness come through. You could tell that it had a little sweetness, but it wasn't overpowering. And the sweetness certainly didn't overpower the classic roastiness of the stout malt bill. It all came through and had its individual voice, and it was really, really quite enjoyable. I think this is about as well-balanced of a non-flavored milk stout that I could name. I gave it a 10 out of 10. Feeling in the intangible? Absolutely loved it. I've had this beer many times, though it had been many, many years. And honestly, it was like reuniting with a long-lost friend. I absolutely loved it and did question why I don't buy this with any regularity. I think I'm going to do that for my daily drinking pleasure, but I give it a 10 out of 10. I loved it. Finally, as an example of the style, I think this is one of the most well-done, well-executed, well-balanced milk stouts I could name. Some of the flavored ones tend to be a bit sweeter and it helps accentuate, like we've done a few flavored milk stouts from Saugatuck. The added sweetness of those definitely helps accentuate the flavors that they're creating in their beer. But just for a standard milk stout, no other flavors, it's the malt bill, but the sweetness from the lactose, this is how to do it. Don't overdo the lactose. Let it be there, let it have a little edge, but let the malt still come through. Let all that deep, rich, roasty edge and even a slight bitterness from the roast come through, and they nailed it. I give it a perfect 10 out of 10. That brings the total score on Left Hand Brewing's Nitro Milk Stout to a 93 out of 100, a very, very high score and well-earned in my opinion. Moving on to beer number two. This is New Holland Brewing's Dragon's Milk White. This is a bourbon barrel white stout, also 6% ABV, and they are based out of Holland, Michigan. Starting with the aroma. The aroma on this one, certainly compared to the prior, was more aggressive. It was a lot more pronounced. You could smell the malt bill. You could smell even some other interesting flavors playing off of the malt bill, and certainly the bourbon came through. It was above average in that respect, for sure. I give it an 8 out of 10. For the taste, I really, really enjoyed the taste on this beer. Very, very nice. A lot of different interesting complex flavors that came through, and as well as the woody character from the barrel and the bourbon, and they all got really their own voice. There were a few aspects I wish would have been a little more intense than others. I would have liked a little more of the malt character, the roasted edge of the malt to come through, but you know, minor nitpick. I only docked 1 point. I gave it a 9 out of 10. For the body on this one. The body is where this one fell a little flat for me. At 6%, you know, it's not a huge ABV. Certainly for a stout, it's kind of in the higher end of average, but the body just felt like it had virtually no substance. I mean, it wasn't flat, it wasn't watery, but at 6% and a stout with all that malty goodness, I did expect it to have a lot more robust body and a lot more presence in my mouth. I just said it was average. I gave it a 5 out of 10. Mouthfeel. Mouthfeel is another category that surprised me. You know, stouts in general, even if it's not pulled from a tap, just due to the nature of the beast, they're going to be a bit silkier than the average mouthfeel from your average beer, often akin to, say, a cream ale. But this didn't really have that. It wasn't particularly effervescent either, that was kind of all that activity ruining the mouthfeel. It just never really developed for me. It was a little bit there, but you know, it really didn't escape the average realm. I expected it to be a lot more silky and creamy than it were. I gave it a high end of average. I gave it a 6. Finish on this beer. Nice beer, certainly a longer finish than on the prior, though being that it was bourbon barrel aged, I expected it to last longer than it did. It had a reasonably decently long finish. Don't get me wrong, it was certainly above average, but with the barrel aging, I did expect that to take it even longer into top tier status. As it were, I give it an 8 out of 10. Moving on to head and retention. Head and retention formed pretty well on this. It was certainly above average, but no nitro, and seeing them side by side, you can see what a difference that makes. 8 out of 10 it gets for head and retention. Appearance, this was textbook white stout. I know it's interesting if you don't drink a lot of them, never seen one before. That's the deal, hence their name. Perfect 10 out of 10. Balance on this. I enjoyed this beer. I did think it was very, very well balanced overall. Just a couple of minor nitpicks and elements I would have liked to have a bit more presence, but I only docked 1 point on there. I give it a 9 out of 10. Feeling in the intangible, I really, really enjoyed this beer. It was very interesting, and indeed the flavors it developed, I didn't actually anticipate. And I kind of got a little hint of that from the aroma, so I shouldn't have been that surprised, but kind of these chocolate undertones that came through, especially seeing it as a white stout, I was really quite taken aback, and it was very enjoyable. I give it a 9 out of 10. Finally, as an example of the style, I think this is a very well done white stout, as a white stout certainly. As a barrel aging, I enjoyed it subjectively even more, though I did expect some more intensity created by the barrel that didn't quite come through. Just a few minor nitpicks with a couple categories, but it did affect the final score. I did dock 2 points as an example of the style. It gets an 8, but that's still certainly well above average. That brings the total score on the New Holland Dragon's Milk White to an 80 out of 100. So we're looking at what seems pretty significant, a 13-point spread here, 93 versus 80. But don't get me wrong, these are both fantastic beers and completely different. They may both be stouts, but the nitro standard and milk version versus a barrel-aged and white stout, I mean, they're almost completely different animals. So it's really personal preference. What do you like? What do you not like? Both of these beers I absolutely loved, and I certainly recommend them to anybody that is looking for some new stouts. Folks, that's today's review. As always, I do sincerely appreciate you tuning in today. Please don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and if you want to stay in the loop when our videos go live to YouTube, you can click the notification bell icon. It is right next to the subscribe button. Till next time, keep it beer, keep it craft. We'll see you on the next one. Cheers.